Kate, why are you so glued to this book this morning? Won't you talk to me today?
Princess, you won't understand. I have never seen a book like this before, giving me amazing insight to my nightmare and giving me the strategies on how to deal with some terrible dreams I do have.
Oh, wait. Is it your dreams and interpretation by Pastor Paul S. Joshua?
Yes, so.
Wow, I have read it. No wonder. It's really an amazing book. Since I read it, I stopped having terrible nightmares and I learned how to understand and handle my nightmares.
What are you waiting for? Get your dreams and interpretation by Pastor Paul S. Joshua.
A book with insightful revelation on your nightmares. It also provides you with scriptural strategies to handle all your dreams.
It provides solutions to swimming in the dream, wet dreams, eating with dead people, climbing mountains, and a lot more.
Hurry, get your copy at the church location for retail and bulk purchase. Call 0803-440-0914, 0803-440-0914, or visit www.refinershouse.com.
Welcome to your dream and its interpretation. How are you doing today? I'm Paul S. Joshua. I'm glad to be here to interpret the dreams that you have sent to me. And if you're just watching this channel for the first time, I want to welcome you to this channel. It's a beautiful channel and I would advise you to subscribe to this channel. You have any dream bothering you, you just had to drop your dream under the comment section and at my free time, I will interpret your dream. Don't forget the rules. Tell me your name. Number two, tell me where you are sending your dream from. And number three, try as possible to make your dream brief. In other words, summarize your dreams, okay? So I can go straight to handle your dream. And before I interpret the dreams that you have sent today, let me tell you three things or three kinds of dream that indicate the devil is out to destroy your life. There are three dreams that when you start having them, then just understand that the devil is ready to ruin your life, is out to destroy your life. So you must be very careful when you have such dreams to make sure you resist them, you fight them, and you kick against every strategy of the devil to ruin you. Otherwise, you might just be surprised that your life will be wasted. So these three dreams are: number one, when you regularly find that you have sex in the dream, you know, somebody making love to you, sleeping with you, people you don't know, or a face you know, or you don't know the face, and always making love with you, you must contend with that dream. Because with that, the devil is out to destroy your life. So when you regularly have sex in dream, that means the devil is out to destroy your life. You must fight against it. Some of you might even see maybe male to male or female to female making love to you. Lesbianism, homosexualism, that's not a good dream. Fight it and make sure you deal with it. It's not a good dream. Number two, when you see yourself all the time naked in the dream or beaten by rain, the devil is also out to destroy you. He wants to ruin your career, ruin your reputation. So you must make sure you rise up and pray against it. When you regularly find out that in the dream you are naked, or you notice that you are beaten by rain all the time in your dream, naked, wet, just find yourself naked, that is the devil is out to really ruin your reputation, to destroy everything about you. So you must make sure you fight seriously against that such kind of dream. If you don't do that, I'm sure not quite long, you just notice your reputation is mad, it's ruined. So these are the kind of dreams that prove that the devil is out to destroy you. You must not take such kind of trend for granted. Don't take it for granted at all. Make sure you combat it, make sure you fight it, and make sure you pray against it all the time. You stand on the word of God and fight such kind of dream of seeing yourself naked. Another thing, when you see masquerade all the time in your dream, masquerade chasing you in your dream, you fighting with the masquerade, or you see mad people in your dream, you fighting with a mad person in your dream, the devil is out to attack you with terrible depression. He want to frustrate your life and destroy your destiny. You must make sure you lift up your voice with all vigor to call upon God to frustrate every power that want to ruin your destiny. So when you are having this kind of dream, you don't take it for granted. That is a sign that the devil want to actually destroy or waste your life. So you don't take it for granted. You don't just sleep over it. You need to stand and pray before it's too late. Otherwise, you find yourself in destruction. You find the devil ruin everything about you. So these are some of the dreams that the devil try to attack you with. Once you see that dream, don't take it for granted, all right? So let me quickly attend to some of the dream that has been sent to me today, okay? I got this dream from Blessing. And that is Rian. He said, "Blessing, Pastor. Today I dream of my husband is married with my cousin, and I was so sad and upset, and I saw him was happy. What is the meaning?" And that is Riham. That is Riham from Jordan. You send your dream, Riham from Jordan, to see your husband married to your sister in the dream and he was happy while you were sad. That is to tell you that the devil also here is out to attack your marriage. You want to fight your marriage. So you must seriously pray against any devil that want to come into your home and destroy your marriage. All right? Your marital bliss. Pray against that and also put a watch on your husband. Pray for him and stand by him all the time. Make sure you do your own responsibility as a woman so that the devil will not use any loophole to come in. The Bible says, give no room for the devil, all right? So protect your marriage. Do all possible to make sure you are a good woman for your husband so he won't be tempted to look outside. The devil won't succeed in your marriage in Jesus' name. So that is your dream, Reham from Jordan. God bless you. All right, I pick the next one. All right, and this one is a testimony and a dream. All right, that is Elsa from Kenya. You say, thank you for I got a job today. My husband last week also got a job. Funny enough, my husband helped me to get this one. The Holy Spirit through you stated it in the first dream I ever typed to you. So this is a testimony. Okay, I'm happy to hear the testimony that after I interpreted the dream for you, Elsa from Kenya, that now God gave your husband a job and he also gave you a job. I'm happy to hear that. And then you said you had a dream that I saw Jesus on the cross and he was on fire but not being consumed. What could it be? All right, to see Jesus on the cross and he was on fire but he was not consumed actually is a parable. It's a message to you, and that is you going through a tough time, but the tough time did not swallow you or destroy you. That is what it means here. All right, Jesus on the cross and the fire burning, but he was not consumed. So God is showing you here what happened to you, the experience you had, that you went through tough time, but him, the Lord, kept you. He did not allow the tough time to consume you. So it's a wonderful one. You need to give God praise and thanks for the victory that he has given you. So I celebrate you and I appreciate God for what he's done for you. Just like I said, God speak to us in dream. As you got the meaning of your dream now, and then God was able to provide a job for your husband and also provide for you. So the Lord bless you and keep your family going. That's your dream. Elsa from Kenya. God bless you. All right, I got this one. It said Donnell? Okay, I think Donnell from USA. You said, hey man, I had a dream that I was in a video game superhero type movie scenario, and there was red dots on a map and they appear to be dogs. Then I was warning people that Venom is coming, and following that dream I was on a bunk bed laughing and talking to my crew. And following that dream, it was day time and was getting chased by Thanos. And but I was blessed that I made it inside a store and he did not get in. So, all right, that is Donnell from USA. Okay, your dream in this context actually is an indication of a disaster or something horrible coming, and God through you is passing the warning. And also, as he's passing the warning, as you are instructing people about an imminent disaster, maybe as you are talking to people about the message of salvation, now don't forget also to take necessary precaution and to take proactive measure on getting yourself also saved. You know, you don't just tell people, oh, get saved, get delivered, give your life to Christ, the message of salvation, but you neglect yourself. No, in this context, while you are telling people danger is coming, you also must take a step to escape the danger. So while we proclaim the salvation of God, you also make sure you are safe so that you don't become victim of circumstance that after you have invited others into salvation, you yourself become a castaway. So I think it's a guide for an assignment that God has given you. Make sure that as you are doing that assignment, you also stand strong so you don't lose the blessing of what you are doing. So that is your dream, Donnell from USA, okay? All right, I pick another dream, and that is from Christy. Christy, also, you are from USA. You said this is your first time on this channel. Oh, I'm glad to have you, Christy. Is it Christine or Christine? You are most welcome. I'm happy to have you on this channel, and I do hope you have subscribed already. All right, you said you had a dream that I was sitting in a class, and the girl behind me tried to steal my phone from my back pocket, but I caught her. Later, I received a video call on this phone from an old friend I haven't seen in years, asking me that have I sent or received his mail, which I replied no. And later that night, that same girl was near my front door with her friend, and I opened my door primarily to grab my things before they stole them and tried to befriend them, but they grabbed me and tried to attack me. Well, your dream here actually is a very sharp and strong message, and that is to be careful of falling into the hands of wrong relationship, all right? And also be careful that you don't lose precious virtues that are in your life, something precious that God has put in you, a gift and a character, you know, that is awesome, wonderful character. Don't let anybody take it away from you. Don't let circumstance take away something good that God has deposited in your life. Don't let anything take away your prayer ability, your ability to talk to God, your ability to study, your ability to be patient, any sort of great or good virtue. That's what this dream is standing for. The devil wants to take a virtue in your life, to steal something precious that God has put in you. Don't give room for that, okay? And it shall be well with you. That is your dream, Christine, all the way from USA. The Lord will keep you. You will not be victim of circumstance, and it shall be well with you. God bless you. Other one sack and take you, because my time is up on this video. But I'll see you in subsequent episode. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. God bless you. Don't forget, drop your comment. Let me know how this video is a blessing to you, okay? And don't forget to also like this video. Also share it on your various social media platforms. And also subscribe to this channel if this is the first time you are watching. You have dreams, just drop them there. And I'll be back to interpret them for you in the subsequent episode. God bless you. My partners all over the world, the Lord bless you. Keep supporting my ministry, and it shall be well with you in Jesus' name. I see you in the subsequent episode. Knowing what your dream means is very vital to your safety. I'm Paul S. Joshua. See you again next time. Bye.
Kate, why are you so glued to this book this morning? Won't you talk to me today?
Princess, you won't understand. I have never seen a book like this before, giving me amazing insight to my nightmare and giving me the strategies on how to deal with some terrible dreams I do have.
Oh, wait. Is it your dream that is interpretation by Pastor Paul S. Joshua?
Yes, so.
Wow, I have read it. No wonder. It's really an amazing book. Since I read it, I stopped having terrible nightmares and I learned how to understand and handle my nightmares.
What are you waiting for? Get your dreams and interpretation by Pastor Paul S. Joshua.
A book with insightful revelation on your nightmares. It also provides you with scriptural strategies to handle all your dreams.
It provides solutions to swimming in the dream, wet dreams, eating with dead people, climbing mountains, and a lot more.
Hurry, get your copy at the church location for retail and bulk purchase. Call 0803-440-0914, 0803-440-0914, or visit www.therefinershouse.com.